It's interesting to know that mRNA is it's not a new technology, but as you're alluding to, we are discovering new ways to use it to treat and prevent illnesses and disease. Moderna was founded in 2010, and since that time, we've worked actually to build the industry's leading mRNA technology platform. Our mRNA platform, its speed, scale, and flexibility is uniquely suited to tackle rare disease. And it's because we believe that mRNA therapeutics can be tailored, as I tried to show you with the different enzymes that are missing in methylmalonic acidemia and propionic acidemia, but then also can be scaled to provide urgent intervention, as we've seen with the vaccine, and has the potential to then restore the activity of these missing enzymes that are responsible for each of these various rare diseases. All mRNA medicines start with identifying a protein, and that protein is designed to prevent or treat a certain disease. And mRNA can essentially teach the body how to make a specific protein that can help your immune system prevent disease and also help your body treat previously untreatable diseases. mRNA is in all of our cells. It is an essential component of living organisms and has been in cells for billions of years. But when your body does not make the right type of protein or the right amount, it can cause conditions like cancer or metabolic diseases, including rare disease. Each mRNA carries a unique set of instructions to make a very specific protein. And so these instructions are like the blueprint. So what we are doing is we're delivering these instructions and putting the two cells so that the cells can then take those instructions and put together the right protein to restore the defect. So basically, mRNA is really teaching our body how to make its own medicine, which will help the immune system and other organs treat and prevent certain diseases. Vaccines are given, as we all know, as an injection, but future mRNA treatments may be delivered by an infusion, so an intravenous infusion, such as propionic acidemia and MMA. But in addition to the vaccines and these diseases, we're looking at other areas, as I mentioned at the beginning, such as cancer, other metabolic diseases, cardiovascular disease, and more.